Sí. Hello, my name is Facundo Javier Gelati. I'm a... Sí. ¿Ahora sí?
Sí.
Bueno. Sí. My name is Facundo Javier Gelati. I'm an advanced student of Engineering System of Information here at the UTN. This is my second year participating in the conference, and this is the first time I give a talk, and also it's the first time that I talk in English in front of so many people, so forgive me if I mispronounce something. And okay, about the presentation, I will show you a web application that I developed in my free time that to help students to prepare for exam in of the German language. So I divided the talk in three sections. The first one is the problem, in which I tell you what is the problem that the application solves. The second is the solution from an external point of view, in which I show you the application from a user point of view. And the third section, and the most interesting for me, is the solution from an internal point of view, in which I tell you about the experience I had building the app and the influence that Smalltalk had on it. Because I will try to show you the things that I learned by using Smalltalk and its tools that I could then apply using another programming languages. So the problem. Here at the UTN, we have a lot of scholarships in which the students we can apply for. One of them is the UTN DAD, which is a scholarship program to go to study in Germany. It requires a certificate of German language proficiency. Here is a reference of the levels of the language. The language level required for that scholarship is B1 in German. So, the DAD offers a free exam called ONDAF for the students who are pre-selected to the scholarship. The ONDAF is a set test. And what is a set test? Well, here is an example of a text from the ONDAF exam. A set test is a series of texts which have the part of some words missing, and the goal is to complete the missing letters. We have a limited time for each text, and the level of the language, the final level, is according to the score we have on this test. So this is the way we practice in class, on paper. That has a series of problems. For example, it takes time to check our answers, and also to compute the final score, and to control the time. We manually control the time. And that is different from what we will be doing on the exam, because we take the exam on a computer. So this is where my app comes in. So, the second section of that, the solution from an external point of view. The idea of the application is to let the teacher design the exams she wants in text format. So, the teacher writes this text. We decided to mark the missing parts of the word in square brackets. So then, these texts are loaded into the application, and the application simulates the exam. So I will show you a demo. So here we have the application. That it's a web application runs in a web browser. We have text file, for example, this text one, that have text in the format I showed you. So I could drag this into the application. And the application shows the title of the text. So it interprets the content of the file of the files and show the title. So when I click in Start Exam, it starts the exam. As you can see, the format is exactly the same as the web exam. These images aren't loaded because I have no internet. I can complete here, for example, say, or cualquier cosa, anything.
That's correct, right?
Sure. Then I, when I click here, that it should show you the same button that appears on the exam. In fact, I fetch in the image from the website of the exam. That's the reason I don't have it now. Then it present me the second text. And at the end, it computes the total score. For example, here I have three points and a level A2 or less. And it gives me feedback about what word I completed right and what word I completed wrong. Well, so that's the solution from an external point of view. Now, the solution from an internal point of view. So I decided to implement the application, of course, in Java. I'm joking. When I decided to develop the app in Smalltalk, I researched about some of the technologies that I have to develop it. I already knew Faro, and I was very familiar with the development environment and tools, but I couldn't make an application that runs in a web browser with Faro. I did not in a way that I know how to do it. So I found Amber Smalltalk. So I use Faro and Amber Smalltalk. Amber Smalltalk gives me the opportunity to interact with JavaScript. I can write Smalltalk code that compiles to JavaScript, and I can interact with the libraries that I have written in JavaScript. So I will show you. This is the IDE of Amber. I will. And here in the web browser, I will open the console. And I could do, for example, this. When I run that, it prints hello in the console. I can also assign, for example, thank you. A equals 2 in the JavaScript console, and when I print it in Amber, it's 2. And could also modify the value in Smalltalk, and then here in the console, it's 3. It's modified. So, Amber allowed me to go from Smalltalk to JavaScript and back. But it doesn't have all of the amazing tools that Faro had. For example, the debugger and the refactoring tools. So what to do? So I decided to develop what I could in Faro and then export it into Amber. That forced me to decouple the application into two main components. A core component, which has all the logic that I developed it in Faro, and a presentation component, which has the UI that I developed it using Amber. The code that I developed using Faro, I exported into Amber. But the passing from Faro to Amber was slow. And I must file out the changes, copy the files, and execute some commands. So I developed a tool that does that for me, a tool for exporting Faro code to Amber. So I will show you a demo of the tool. So here I am in Faro. I will make a new class. For example, I don't know. So I have a new class. And then I can run this tool. I say to it that I want to export these two packages. And to Amber Inn and the location in where I have the Amber code. When I run this, it exports me to Amber. And I can, here I have the Amber code, but I must refresh it, but I will show you that I didn't have the class. When I refresh the page, now I have here a new class in Amber. So, I really think that I decided to build this tool only because I was doing it in Smalltalk, because I could explore the system in ways that I cannot in other languages. I think that it's something that, for example, we saw in Laura's talk in the press Smalltalks, when she explained how we can modify the system in an easy way, and I think that I learned this from Smalltalk. So, one of the conclusions is that make tools that help in your work and automate what you can automate. And I learned that from doing Smalltalk. Of course, I can do it also in Java, but the practice of doing that, I get used to it by using Smalltalk. So, when I started to design the application, I didn't know where to start. So I decided to begin by defining a metaphor in which to base my design. And this is something that I didn't used to do before learning Smalltalk. So this is the metaphor I came up with. So we have a source of the text of the exam. And in this case are the text files. Then I imagine what it would look like if I had a team of people doing what I wanted my app to do. So I have a test interpreter which interprets the text. Then it passes it to an exam designer which designs the exam. Then we print the exam. This exam is the specification of the exam. We print copies of it in a printer. The copies are like the form that the student fills in. The student fills in the copy, completes the copy. Then we compare the copies to the original exam and we get a result. So then I could, having this metaphor, I could design my application to match that. So here is an example of an interaction. A quick note about the diagrams. I drew them for this talk to communicate the ideas. I didn't draw them in advance, nor I think they are a complete specification. Originally, I wanted to show you this in the debugger, in the Amber debugger, but I had some problems and I decided to... for example, here I have an object that is an ONDAF simulator. It receives all the events from the UI. For example, when you drop a text. So it receives the message add text with the text. So it says to an exam designer, consider this text to the exam design. The exam designer tells the test interpreter that interpret the test. The test interpreter uses a parser for the title and for the content, and then returns an object that represents the text of the exam, one of the text of the exam. And then the exam designer tells the simulator that it has a new text. So we will show you another example of another interaction, but in the code. So. So, for example, when we press the start exam button, we do this. We tell the exam designer to design the exam. That gives us the specification of the exam. Then we tell a printer to print the exam and we get copies. We say to each copy that when the students finish it, please tell me that begin the new that I begin the new text. The current exam is a stream of the copies. So I have one text, then another, and then I do begin next text. So as you can see, I based the design on a metaphor. And as I said, that is something that I didn't used to do. So base your design on a metaphor. That's another thing that, obviously according to the domain of your problem. That's another thing I learned while doing Smalltalk. The code I developed, I used TDD to develop the code. I think TDD is very useful because it gives me a rapid feedback while I'm developing. But I had some challenges when building the UI. So I decided, well, I can do the UI the old way. So I started building the UI like I used to do. Then I found that it was a long time before I could get feedback about what I was developing. For example, when I was developing the view that showed the result of the exam, when I make a change, I must do a whole test to see the results view. So I thought that there was a very long time to receive the feedback, and I decided to break the problem in two parts. The UI, I have the look of it, that I couldn't write test for it, and the data that it has to show, that I could write test for it to obtain the feedback. So, to test the data that must be shown on the view, I created a class called GUI test that has some methods. For example, assert page contains. So if I can test text card test, for example, a text card, this is a test. Assert page contain a title when I show a card. So if I run it, it passes because it shows me the text in the card. But then I have another problem, that is the look of it. I mean, this text could be small, large, red, green. So for doing that, I created a class that only I use only to contain some code. For example, here, result view, code that I can evaluate and shows me directly the view I want to modify. So then I linked the source of the CSS from Chrome to my disk. So I can modify the CSS here, for example, can make the background red, and I have instant feedback about what I'm doing. So why I decided to do all of that? Because with Smalltalk, I get used to a very small feedback cycle. For example, when I develop in the debugger. So I was bothered by all the time that it takes me to have the feedback. So the feedback cycle must be quick. So another thing that I learned is, for example, if you remember, we have a parser for the text. When implementing the parser, I had an idea. This is a simplified view of the idea I had. And that represents more or less my mental model of what I wanted, what I wanted to implement. So at first, I decided to implement it like this. I have a class called parser state and one subclass for each one of the possible states. But then, when I saw the code, there was something that I didn't like, and I found some duplication of the logic in the subclasses. So I started refactoring, and the thing I did was to reconcile the differences between the subclasses. So at the end, I only have one class that I show you now. which is this, that I can configure the instances. For example, with the message when receive read a character, then transition to the state and do an action. So the final code looked like this. And I think that after the refactoring, the code was much more like my mental model of the parser. For example, I have waiting when letter state reading word. Waiting when letter go to state reading word, for example. Or reading word when read a curly brace, then state reading suffixes. So the code, for me, the code is a model. And when your mental model changes, you must refactor the code to reflect it. So that was another thing that I learned by doing Smalltalk. So the conclusion. First, automate all the things. One example was when I created a tool from exporting the code from Faro to Amber. A metaphor helps to design. Feedback is key, for example, with test or programming while the program executes. And a truly iterative and incremental development. For example, I can test before code with TDD, or I can change the design after code with refactoring. That these are some of the techniques that emerge with Smalltalk. So I think that these techniques are very useful, and by programming Smalltalk and interacting with the Smalltalk community, I learned to think about a very different way of how to develop software. That it's not like the classic view of, well, you do analysis, then design, you draw the diagrams, and then generate the code. So I think that it helped me a lot, and it really changed the way I think about making software. So thank you. I can show you an example. What I did was to make a package in Amber in which I implement some of the messages that I don't have implemented in Amber. Most of them are from collection classes, but most of the time I only had to copy the implementation from Faro. I could show you an example. This is the package Faro Compat. Here in the array class, for example, I have this method, for example, select then do. And this is the implementation. So it is nothing weird, but it's necessary if I want to use this message.
We have the same problem.
Yes. I plan to publish it, but first I want to change the name because exporter is not it's not a very good name. Yes. Thank you.
I have a question. How much do you charge for selling this contract?